Today we're going to use the MathPix web browser tool to convert math that has been entered into a PDF and have it exported out as a Word document. And the reason this particular workflow is so important is because you could upload 100 pages of PDF problems. They can be in handwritten format, digital text, or any other type, and MathPix Snip will OCR it. Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. Thank you for joining me today, and let's jump right in.
I have just opened up a PDF that has three different images on it that contain math. In the tags panel, we can determine that these are also images. And what we're going to do is go to our snip.mathpix.com and log into our account. Under the PDF option on the far left, there's a button to upload a PDF. From here, we're going to find our math problems and we're going to upload the file. We then get an option to either open the PDF, convert to a note, or export the file out. I want to convert it to a note just in case I need to make some changes to it. And over on the right-hand side, we get a snapshot as to what the math actually is going to visually look like. And then on the left-hand side, we have all of our math entered properly as either LaTeX or MathML. Next, we can actually export the file by selecting the export button in the top right corner. And we don't want to export to a PDF as it's very challenging to make math accessible inside of a PDF. So I'm going to take this to DocX. Once that file has exported, we can go and open it, and we can determine that the math is now inside of the default equation editor within Microsoft Word. This is a great starting point. Now, if we wanted to get this math converted into something else, I could use the math type option and I could convert all of these OML equations into MathML. This is such a fantastic process for converting large portions of math from a PDF into a Word document that you can then manipulate even further. As always, I can be your personal accessibility expert. Check out the links below this video to find out how I can help you get accessible.
Now, if you haven't done so already, please hit that like and subscribe button for more up-to-date accessibility best practice videos.
Thank you for joining me today, and I'll see you next time.